Today we are going to discuss about the one of the important concept of the data structure, that is the linked list. Linked list you can define as linear collection of the data elements. Linked list is a linear data structure. Linear data structure means that all the elements are stored in the continuous form. Although not in the continuous memory location, but they are linked together. So we can access them continuous way. So that's why the linked list is called the continuous data structure or the linear data structure. Here the data elements that are available in the linked list are called a node. So the node, we can say linked list is a collection of the nodes in which all the nodes are linked together. Now every node that is formed over here, the node is consists of the two parts. Here the first part that is called a data part, and the second part that is called a next, or we can say that it is a pointer to next node. So here this data part is actually used to store the values, and this is the part in the this part of the node that is used to link the next node. Here you can if you interpret that train, then you can form the you can get the interpretation of the linked list. Then here the linked list is consists of the various number of nodes which are linked together with each other. Here you can give the one part of the linked list. Here these are all the nodes are linked together with each other just like a train, and here we are having a pointer that is known as this star, which point to the first node of the linked list. Now here you are seeing that this part is used to show the data part. Now this data part, it can be a simple data. Like you can store here the character, integer, float, and others. Or here we can have some another array. Or we can have some another structure. So within the data part, we can store the simple kind of the data, we can store the arrays, we can store the another structure and all those. And here this is the part which contains the pointer to the next node. Now every node is having of the same type. The pointer that is pointing to the next node is belong to the same part. So that's why linked list is called the self-referential data. Linked list is called self-referential. Now here some other things are available in the linked list. One is that when we come to the last node of the linked list. So in the last node, the next part of the last node is always, it is called a null. Because it is not pointing to any other node. So when we do the programming part, at that time we say we represent this next part as a null pointer, means which is not pointing to anything. Or we can represent the part as a x over here. The linked list is always accessed this the accessed by the starting pointer, which is we are saying as a start. So start is a pointer which is always pointing to the first node of the linked list. So start will always remain fixed, because whenever we have to access the linked list, we always start reversing from the first node onwards. So we have to store the location of the first node. So for that purpose, we are having the start pointer over here, which stores the address of the first node. So once we are having the address of the first node, by the next part of the every node, we are able to access every other node of the linked list. So by this, we are able to traverse in a single direction, and we can access every part of the linked list. So that's why the linked list is also called a linear data structure. Now how we represent the linked list or the node of the linked list in the form of the programming part? So So we represent that thing like this way. Struct node, let's say integer data, then struct node pointer next. So a node can be presented like a structure. So we form a structure. Within that, this is the data part, and this is the pointer to the next node, which is of the same structure type. So we'll say struct node, and is a pointer to the next node. So we represent a node like this. If you get the difference, we can also say that array is also a linear collection of the data elements. So we can form the difference over here, or we can form the similarity between the array and the linked list. The similarity is that array is also called a linear collection of the data elements. In the same way, linked list is also called a linear collection of the data members. In the case of the arrays, all the data members are stored in the continuous memory location. But in the case of a linked list, they are not stored in the continuous memory location, but they are scattered anywhere within the memory, but they are linked together with the help of the pointer. So that's why again we are saying it is a linear collection of the data elements. In the case of the arrays, we are able to access any element directly with the help of the index location. We can go to the any 49, 50th, any elements directly. But in case of the linked list, we are not able to access any node directly. If you have to access any node, then we have to start from the first location, from the starting point, and traverse one by one, and then only we are able to access that node in the linked list. So random access is not possible in the linked list. Like in the case of the arrays, we are able to perform, we can perform the insertion and deletion at any location. In the same way, in the linked list, we can insert a node or delete a node from any location within the linked list. So the insertion and deletion operation is same as the, in the arrays as well as in the linked list. In the case of the arrays, if we the memory space required by the arrays is less, but in case of the linked list, the memory space is required by the linked list is higher, because we are storing the address to the next node. So that is occupying the more memory over here. So although the linked list is much better than the arrays, but here we have to spend some amount of the storage space also. In the case of arrays, if you declare the arrays of certain size during the program, then we cannot increase the size of the arrays. The size, once it is declared, it remains fixed throughout the execution of the program. So let's say if you declare the array of the size 10, then the size of the array will remain fixed throughout the execution of the program. But in case of the linked list, the size of the linked list can get changed during the execution. Because in the case of the linked list, we are having the dynamic memory allocation. But in case of the arrays, we are having the static memory allocation. So in the static memory allocation, the size cannot get changed during the execution. But in case of the dynamic memory allocation, the size can get changed. So the linked list is giving us the flexibility to increase the size during the execution. Now let's look at some of the basic operations that we can perform over the linked list. Initially, we start with the traversing. If you have to traverse within the linked list, means we have to access all the elements of the linked list, then it can be performed in this way. Let's say that we take one example over here. This is the start. This is the first node. Let's suppose this is the linked list, and we have to traverse within this linked list. So As we said that the start is a pointer that always remains fixed at the first mode. If we change the start, then we are not able to access the first mode. Suppose we modify the start and now it is pointing to the second mode. So we are not able to access the first node because the second node does not have the address of the first node. So that's why the start always remains fixed at the first node. Now if we have to traverse within the linked list, then we require one additional pointer. With the help of that, we will move the pointer and we are able to access the individual elements. So it can be written like this. Let's say that we say, let's say we are taking the another pointer ptr, which is the ptr is supposed to start. Second, we'll run while ptr is not equals to null. We keep on moving the ptr up to the ptr is not equals to null, means when it reaches to the end of the linked list. We apply the operation on ptr of data. Any operation can be there. So we apply the operation on the ptr of data. Then we'll move the ptr to the next node. Then we will say here exit. So it is a general algorithm that we have written for the traversing. So here any operation can be performed on the any particular node. So by that we will access the individual node of the linked list and we will move to the next node by the ptr equals to ptr of next. So here if we say that, let's say now that ptr is here, so ptr is supposed to start by this first statement, then we'll apply the operation. So ptr is now pointing to this node, so we'll apply the operation on this node, then move the pointer with the help of ptr to ptr of next. So this is the next part of this ptr of next. So ptr will come over here, we apply the operation on this, then ptr will move over here and as the so on, and when it comes to the end of the node, so our loop will get terminated. Here the operation we can perform, let's say that we want to print all the values, all the values of the node of the linked list. So we can say here that write ptr of data. So by this we can print the value of all the nodes of the linked list. So this is the another way we can take. Or let's say that if you want to count the number of nodes within the linked list. So for that purpose, what we can do? Let's say that we declare one variable over here. Count is equals to 0. Take the pointer at the start. Initialize the while loop up to the pointer is not equals to null. Then here we'll say count is equals to count plus 1. So when the ptr is pointing to this first node, the count will be the 1. Then ptr go to the next node, count will increase by the 1 and so on. And by this it keep on increasing. Then at the fourth we can say write count and then that's it. So by this we are able to count the number of nodes within the linked list. The next part we can take over here that we are performing the insertion. Suppose that some linked list is already given to us and we have to insert a new node within the linked list. So now the insertion can be taken place at the various location. We can insert the node at the start of the linked list, we can insert at the end of the linked list, we can insert in between the linked list, before some node or after some node. So depending on the very other node that we given over here. So various locations are there where we can perform the insertion of the node within the ArrayList. When we do the programming, at that time, whenever we have to perform the insertion or whenever we have to create a new node, we have to get the memory from the system. For getting the memory from the system, we are having the inbuilt functions are available in the C, that is malloc, alloc. If you are going with the C++ or the Java, then we are having the function over here is new. By that we can get the memory from the system to create a new node. There is a dynamic memory location. So but here, as we are writing the algorithm, so we are assuming we are not taking all these inbuilt functions over here. We are saying that we are having a one variable over here, that is avail, that is pointing to a set of free memory location. So we'll take the memory from this avail and move the avail pointer to the next free location. So we are assuming here that avail is a pointer which is pointing to the set of free memory availables in the system. Okay, so this is the first part that we are going to take, that we are perform the insert at top of linked list. At the top of the linked list means we are adding the first node in the linked list. Some linked list is already available with us and we are adding the new node over here. So this is the new node that we are going to insert over here. So let's say we will write like this. First we will check that whether the memory is available with the system or not. So if avail is equals to null, means if the no memory is available, so avail pointer is saying that it is null, then we will say, we will write overflow. Means the memory cannot be taken, memory is exhausted in the system, and we will say go to step, we will exit and we will write the step number over there. The second we will say that if the memory is available, then we will say we will create a new node from the avail and we will get the memory from the avail and assign that name as a new node, and then avail will move to the avail of next. It will move to the next available free location. So we have got the memory and we have created a new node over here. Once this new node is created, this, the name we are saying is a new node. Now in this new node, let's say that I want to insert a value with this node is let's say 9. So I can say here new node of data is equals to value. So I assign the value over here. Now this new node is to be added at the top of this linked list as a first node. So when we add this node, so what will happen that the start will now point to this node, and the next part of this new node will point to this node. Right? So this is the adjustment of the pointer. So how the pointer will get adjusted? Let's say that new node of the next, here we will store the pointer of this node. So where the address of this node is available, that is available with this star. So new node of next will be a star. And now this star will have the address of new node. So new node will have the address of this. New node of next will be the start. So start is pointing to this. And then we'll adjust the start pointer. So start will point to this. So by this, and this is the same mistake, that is exit. So we'll say here that if it's not working, if the memory is not available, so we'll exit from this algorithm. So this is the way we perform the insertion of the new node at the top of the linked list. No, insertion of the node at end of the link list. Now we have to add the new node at the end of the link list. Well, we have to get the new node over here. Again, initial process are the same. Just get the memory from the system, create a new node, move the old pointer to the next node, and assign the value in the data part of it. So this part is over. Now, when we have to insert a new node at the end of the linked list, so we require a one pointer through which we will move up to the end of the linked list, and then only we perform the addition over here. So let's create a one pointer over here. PTR is equals to the start. The PTR pointer is created. We'll move the pointer one by one location. We'll reach over here. So PTR. Then we'll point to the last node. Then we'll insert a new node over here. So we'll write over here while PTR of next is not equals to none. PTR of next. This is the PTR of next is equals to none. So it will stop over here. PTR will point to this one. In the previous algorithm we are saying that PTR is not equals to null. So when the link list is over, so PTR will reach out of the link list. But here in this case we will stop the PTR at the last node. So we'll say PTR of next is not equals to null. So it will come at the last node. You say PTR is equals to PTR of next. PTR is moved at the end of this. Then we'll add a node over there. So in this node, we have to insert a new value. New node of next will be, this is a new node. New node of next, it will become the null. So new node of next will be a null. We already assigned a value. Now the next part of the new node is also registered. And then we will add this new node at the end of the next part of the PTR. So PTR of next will be equals to new node. So this PTR of next is new node. New node of next is null, we have already said. And then ninth is exit. So this value will get changed. This will be the ninth. So by this way, we are able to insert a node at the end of the linked list. Another variation we are going to study is insert after given node. Insert after the given node, suppose we have to add a new node in between this, in between 18 and 27. Let's say the value we have given is 15. We have to insert a node in between. So what we have to do? When the new node is added over here, these two pointers are changes. First, it will point to this, and then it will point to this. So here we require a one pointer over here and one pointer over here, through which we are able to access both the nodes. Because we require the pointer, we have to adjust the pointer of the two different nodes. So we require two pointers over here, through which we are, should be able to access two different nodes. Okay. So we will write the algorithm. The wish lists are the same. If avail is equals to null, then write overflow, go to state, we will write the step number over here. Second, new node is equals to avail is equals to avail of next, then new node of data is equals to value. So new node of data is value. Then next PTR is equals to start. We have taken one pointer PTR at the start. We have taken another pointer pre PTR is equals to PTR. Now the two pointers are there, pre PTR and the PTR. Both are pointing to the first one, right? While pre PTR of data is not equals to none. Suppose we give the value of the null is 18, so we are saying that while the pre PTR of data is not equals to none, means that up to here it comes over here. So pre PTR is set over here. PTR will set over here. So we will say pre PTR is equals to PTR and PTR is equals to PTR next. So at the initial level, what will happen? Initially, the pre-PTR and PTR both are pointing to this. So we have said that pre-PTR of data is not equals to now. We are talking about the 18. So it is not equals to 18. So what we'll do? Pre-PTR and PTR both are here. Then PTR is PTR. So PTR will move from here to here. So pre-PTR is at the previous node, PTR is at the next node. Again, at the next stage, pre-PTR of so PTR is PTR of next node. Then pre PTR of data is not equals to now. So pre PTR equals to PTR. So pre PTR will shift from here to here. And PTR will shift here. At the next stage, again we check the value. 18 is not the same. So pre PTR equals to PTR. So pre PTR came over here at the next node and the PTR came over here. Then we will check again pre PTR of data is not equals to none but it become equals to none, so it will stop over here. So we have find the correct node. Now we have to add the new node at that location. So it will be like this. Pre PTR, this pointed by the PTR, this pointed by the pre PTR, and this is a new node. So pre PTR of next is equals to new node. So that we set the pointer like this. Pre PTR of next equals to new node.
new node of next is equals to PDR. So this pointer, this set, new node of next is equals to PTR, and then 9 is exit. So here we write this step. So by this we are able to create a new node after the given node within the linked list. So this is the insert after the given node. Then the next we are going to study is insert before given node. Let's say this is the current status of the link list. Now we have to insert a new node before the given node. Before is the 27. Right? So before 27, we have to insert a new node. And let's say the value that we want to insert in this new node is, let's say, 15. So we have said, again the same step, our request null will get the memory from the system. If it is not there, then we will say overflow. We will take the new node, we will get the memory, create a new node. Our we will move to the next tree available location. Then the new node of data, we set the value. So value is assigned to the new node. Okay. Again we will set the two pointer, PTR and PTR, because we have to take the pointer of the two different nodes over here. Now here, what we'll say? We'll say that we are saying that before 27 we do it. So we'll move the pointer PTR at this location. So this is the PTR, so we require the pointer for this node also. So this will become pre-PTR. Pre-PTR is always one node before the PTR. So we'll say like this, the loop will modify here. While PTR of data, while PTR of data is not equal to num, what is the num that we are looking for? The 27. So up to here PTR will stop. So initially we will start from here, PTR and PTR both are here on the same node. We will check PTR of data is equal to num, it is not same. So PTR will come over here and PTR will move to the next node. Then again we will check the 5 with the 27, it is not same. So pre-PTR come over here, PTR will move to the next. We'll check 18 with the 27, it is not same. So pre-PTR come over here, PTR will move to the next. We'll check here, it is same, so it will stop. Pre-PTR and PTR both are set over here. Now we'll see next. Now at the pre-PTR of next, we'll set the new node. So this pointer will get removed and it will set like this. Pre-PTR of next is now pointing to the new node. New node of next will point to the PTR and then exit. So only the difference between the previous algorithm and in this algorithm is that only the difference is of the pointer. In the previous algorithm we are saying pre-PTR, that is we are inserting after the given node, and then we are saying pre-PTR. Now in this we are saying before the given node, so we are saying PTR over here. Only the difference is of the this pointer, pre-PTR and PTR. Rest of the things are the same. So by this we are able to insert a node before the given node and after the given node. Now this part we will discuss over here is about the deletion. That is the deletion of a node from the linked list. So again in the deletion, there are the variations are there. if the deletion of a node from the start of the linked list, deletion of a node from the end of the linked list, deletion of a node somewhere within the linked list after the given node or before the given node, and so on. So different deletions can be adopted over here. So let's start. Then the deletion of a node at the start of the linked list. So let's say this is the node that we want to delete, the first node. So how the deletion will take place? When we delete this, the start pointer, which is now pointing to this node, will now point to the next node. So how it can be done? So for this, we require first, if start is equals to none. What is the condition of the empty linked list? The condition of the empty linked list is that if the start is not pointing to anything, means there is no node is available in the linked list, and the linked list is called the empty node, empty linked list. So same thing here, that we'll check for the empty linked list. If the list does not have any nodes, then we cannot perform any deletion over here. So we'll check if the start is equals to null, then write underflow. Means no node is exists in the linked list and we cannot perform the deletion. Then go to step, we'll write the step number over here. Now here you have to delete this node. So if you deleted the node directly, then where the start will point? So first we have to adjust the start. Now if you move the start over here, then we cannot access this node because we have lost the pointer of this node. So we require one pointer over here for this node, then we will move the start and then perform the deletion. So we set the one pointer ptr to this node. Then we will move the start from here to here to the next node, and then we will delete the ptr. So we will say ptr is equals to the start. So ptr is now pointing to the start. Then third, start is equals to the start of next. So now start will move to the next node, that is the start of next node over here. And then we will say free ptr. Actually free is the system call through which we can deallocate the memory that we had taken from the system. So free ptr, and then fifth is the exit. This is the step number. So by this we can delete a first node from the linked list. That is the deletion from the start of the linked list. Next, we have to discuss that we have to delete the node from the end of the linked list. From the end, or the last node of the linked list. So, when we have to delete the last node of the linked list, we require a one pointer, because we have to traverse within the linked list. The start cannot be moved, so we require one pointer through which we will traverse within the linked list and we will come at the ptr will come over here. Now when the ptr will come over here, we require one pointer also over here, because if we delete this node, then how will we access this node? Because when this node is deleted, this node will become the last node, and for this last node, this should be marked as a null. So for this we require one pointer, that is the pre-ptr. Once this node is deleted, the previous node should be accessible to set the next part. So for this we will say while, first set the pointer,
PTR is equals to the start. So PTR is here. Then third while PTR of next is not equals to null. The same as we are following, PTR of next is not equals to null. We'll say print PTR is equals to PTR. So we set another pointer over here, print PTR. This is pointing to this, this is pointing to this. Now PTR of next is not null, so print PTR is set over here. Then we will move the PTR to the next node. So PTR equals to PTR of next. So PTR came over here. Next part. Then again we'll check PTR of next is not null. So PTR came over here. PTR move next. Then PTR of next is not null. So PTR came over here. PTR will come over here. Then PTR of next is not null. So PTR come over here. PTR come over here. Then PTR of next now it is null. So it will stop. So these two pointers are set like this. Now in this we'll say print PTR of next is set is it null. So now this part print PTR of next is set is a null. And then we'll say free PTR. PTR will be removed from the PTR. And then sixth is exit. So this is the step number 6. So this way we are able to delete the node from the end of the linked list. Now the next we are discussing is deletion after given node. After the given node. Let's say that I want to delete a node 27 after the 18. Means whatever node is there after the 18, I want to delete that thing. So in that case, we require a pointer. When we delete the 27, we require one pointer over here, one pointer over here. Because after deletion, this pointer will get adjusted. Both 18 and 20 get linked together. So, in this case, we have to move one pointer print PTR over here. We require one pointer PTR over here. Then only we are able to perform the deletion of the 27, means after the 18. So again, we start from this. If first we'll check for the empty. So if the start is equals to null, then write underflow. Then go to state, we'll write step number set. Let's say PTR is equals to start, pre PTR is equals to PTR.
Now we are saying that you have to delete a node after the 18.
So we'll say while pre-PTR of the data is not equals to num.
Here the value of num is 18. Pre-PTR of data is 10, 5, 18, all this other data this. So we'll check.
So we say pre-PTR here and PTR here. Both are here.
Pre-PTR data is not equals to num. So we'll say pre-PTR is equals to PTR and PTR is equals to PTR of next.
So we take the two pointer. Now we are moving pre-PTR and PTR on the adjacent node.
When they come at this location, so the location will be like this. Pre-PTR will be here and PTR will be here by this loop. Okay, now you say that pre-PTR of next, pre-PTR of next will have the address of the PTR of next. So here we store the address of this node. So where the address of this node is available? In the PTR of next. So we'll say pre-PTR of next will have the address of this node which is available in the PTR of next. So PTR of next will be the PTR of next. So in this we will store this address, right? And then fifth is free PTR. Sixth is exit. So this is a deletion after the given node from the linked list. The next we are going to discuss is deletion from sorted linked list. Let's say 10, 15, 18, 21, 27. Suppose our linked list is in the sorted order form. And we have to perform the deletion from this. So how that thing will take place? Here we will search within the linked list about that particular data that we want to delete. Right? Let's say we want to delete a node 18 from this. So we will search for the 18 and adjust the pointer based on it. So we say that we are looking for the 18, so we will take the pointer PTR over here and we will take the pointer pre-PTR over here. So that we can modify this, we can perform the deletion and pre-PTR of next will set to the address of the PTR of next. So these are the steps remain same. PTR is at the start, pre-PTR is at the PTR. We'll say while pre-PTR of data is not equals to num. We'll look for the 18. So pre-PTR of data is not equals to num. Pre-PTR will be the PTR. PTR will be the PTR of next. Now it is not a pre-PTR, it is PTR. While PTR of data means 18, PTR will set over here. So PTR of data is not close to num up to here. So we will stop here when the PTR at this location. These are the set. Now we will say pre-PTR of next will be equals to PTR of mix. Means we have at this stage we store the address of this node. And then we'll say free PTR at exit. So this node will get deleted from here. And our linked list get modified. So only the things we modify over here is instead of the pre-PTR, like in the previous algorithm, now we are saying it is a PTR update. So by this we can perform the deletion from the sorted linked list. So with this, we have completed a single linked list.